Hi, and thanks for dropping by. Let's take a look about finding out where to put a piano from interiordesign.com. I'm Lee Brown and I'll take you through some key factors on this today so you can understand the best place to put your piano in your living room. So where is the best place to put your piano in the living room? An internal wall, away from direct sunlight, away from any humidity, keep away from heat sources, and somewhere accessible. If you're lucky enough to own your own piano and you know how to play, you can be in a quandary when you move house as you don't know where the best place to put your piano is for the best musical effect and for the well-being of your instrument. It all boils down to what kind of piano you have and the purpose of that piano. If the piano will be used by children who are taking lessons, a different position is in order than that of a grand piano, which will be used by a seasoned pianist to entertain guests as well as playing for pleasure. You can see in this photo, this is a great place for regular practice and playing. It's accessible, it's on an internal wall, and it's away from any drafts and sunlight. However, as you can see, if we move back into the room a bit more, there could be a lot of vibration and dust from the open stair above, so it may not be the perfect spot. There are fast and steady rules that apply to uprights, as well as grands and baby grands. All pianos must be well placed so they are not affected by fluctuating temperatures and humidity in the living room. Having a well insulated modern home will differ from an older, less insulated home that can be drafty. Fluctuations in temperature or humidity or both can affect the tone quality of the piano and in some instances do damage to their inner workings. Whilst we all love natural sunlight, it's great for being able to read sheet music, but it's not great for the piano. Where possible, keep the piano away from the direct sunlight and from any drafts from windows. Consider temperature control. If you want to place the piano in your living room and are uncertain as to the temperature or humidity equation, you may want to install a specialised unit inside the piano that controls the interior temperature. It's like when you walk into an IT department at your workplace and the room seems to be freezing. The department managers know they must maintain a certain temperature for the equipment to run efficiently. Experts say that cold temperatures do more damage to the piano than anything else. If you are budget conscious, you may want to place a tiny humidifier inside the instrument rather than purchase an installed heater. Also, experts say that if you have either of these systems for your piano, you must keep the lid open at all times. This will mean that you'll have maximum volume when playing, which can be a noise factor, which we will also discuss. But another factor to consider is don't position your piano in the vicinity of an air conditioning unit or a duct to heat. You don't want major changes in temperature. Even though you want to have your piano in your living room, you should never put it by a window. This seems to be a good idea so that the player can read the sheet music by natural light. However, windows can let in drafts and humidity, which are two things you want to avoid for your expensive instrument at all costs. Even if these factors are not issues, the noise level for your neighbours would be another. You can see in this image that the piano is positioned on an internal wall, so it's got easy access for regular playing. It creates minimal noise for the neighbours as it's away from the windows and it's away from any heat sources. Now we enter into the noise factor. If you are an accomplished player, neighbours will probably enjoy the music from time to time. If this is the case and you have an upright piano, it's appropriate to place it against an outside wall. The music will definitely filter out unless you have soundproofed your living room, which very few people do. You could also consider the type of music you're playing and whether or not it could affect your neighbour's sensibilities. If you play rock and roll and live next door to a retired couple, placing your upright on an outside wall would not be a good idea. If you have children who are taking lessons and are not accomplished players, an interior wall is probably the best option. You can see here in this image that this grand piano has wheels so it can be moved out for a performance, which is ideal, keeping it away from those windows and the radiators as well. Don't forget the sound of the piano. I don't want to provide too many factors for making decisions, but when it comes to making music, it's important to think about how the sound will reverberate around the room. Make sure you have some soft furnishings to absorb some of the sound and make it a pleasant listening experience. This can be easily achieved by using carpet or floor rugs, curtains or drapery, and upholstered furniture, as you can see in this image. Whether you have an upright, grand or baby grand and you have to leave the lid open, more sound will escape from the instrument. When you have a grand piano, you want to place it where the lid opening is closest to the people who will be listening, your guests. You can place it with the keys facing the outside wall because the sound will be coming from the front of the unit. If you have novice players, you may want to place your piano in the living room facing an interior wall. You can see on this image that it's a great piano placement. The piano lid will open up facing the audience. Unfortunately, it is right beside a radiator and two windows, which is not ideal placement for this living room if it's to stay in that position. When you're thinking about decorating when you position your piano in the living room, it will be the focal point of the room. Decorate it around it to play up to its importance. You want to place sofas and chairs where the visitors can get the most enjoyment from your playing. Sometimes you may have a piano but no one to play it and it merely becomes a piece of decorative furniture. It's still best to think about the environment and the position of the piano for when you get a guest who may want to entertain you. It's a musical instrument and we want to look after it. Be careful having houseplants sitting on a piano. We don't want water to damage the timber or the workings of the instrument. You can see that it's not easy to find a good home for your piano. There are so many factors to take into consideration. But the most important factor is to focus on the well-being of the instrument, and then you can follow with the aesthetics of where it is placed for best enjoyment by all. Have fun, and I hope you love playing and listening to your piano. You can see here that sometimes pianos in this photo, sometimes pianos just become a decorative piece, which is a shame, but they do have a lot of design merit. Okay, in summary, here are our key factors to consider. We want to place it on our piano on an internal wall. We want to keep it away from any direct sunlight and away from humidity, also away from any direct heat sources. We want it to be somewhere accessible so that we can actually sit down and play it whenever we feel like it. We want to allow for soft furnishings in the room to help with that, getting the best sound that we can. And most of all, we want to focus on the well-being of the instrument, as that's our primary focus. Hey, thanks for watching to the end, much appreciated. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'll have a lot more of these wonderful informative videos coming on stream. Visit our website at interiordesign.com. You can register and get a few free e-courses via email. So we've got a course on interior decorating, colour and curtain design. So that's it from me, Lee Brown, today from interiordesign.com. It's been great having you here. Have fun. Hopefully you know now where you can place your piano and life will be a bit better and you'll enjoy listening to that music. Have a great day. See you. Bye bye.